Good day, everyone. I am Hale Shane Tumundong, your presenter for today. And today, I will be discussing the novice and expert learners. So without further ado, let us start. Novice learners, a person who has no specific knowledge about the topic. Novice learners are beginners who are learning the fundamentals of acquiring new knowledge or skills. That is, they have no prior knowledge or they only have limited knowledge of a particular subject or areas. For novice learners, it is extremely difficult to determine the essential parts of the learning materials needed in the constructive process, which means that as educators, we need to carefully select the relevant information. Now let us move on to expert learners. Expert learners has a wealth of knowledge in a specific field or domain. So expert learners are those learners that want to be successful on their first go round of learning. This may take some time, therefore, teachers must provide challenges to a student who wants to be expert, and the teacher should only feed it with the correct strategies to maintain the motivation and even increase it. However, expert learners should accept failure at some points because this will help them to succeed. Expert learners are strategic, goal-directed learners, second, resourceful, knowledgeable learners, and third, purposeful, motivated learners. So why expert learners are strategic, goal-directed learners? It's because they formulate plans for learning and devise effective strategies and tactics to optimize learning. They organize resources and tools to facilitate learning. They monitor their progress toward mastery. They recognize their own strengths and weaknesses as learners, and they abandon plans and strategies that are ineffective. Next, expert learners are resourceful, knowledgeable learners because they bring considerable prior knowledge to new learning. They activate that prior knowledge to identify, organize, prioritize, and assimilate new information. They recognize the tools and resources that would help them find, structure, and remember new information, and they know how to transform new information into meaningful and usable knowledge. And lastly, expert learners are purposeful, motivated learners because their goals are focused on mastery rather than performance. They know how to set challenging learning goals for themselves and how to sustain the effort and resilience that reaching those goals will require. They can monitor and regulate emotional reactions that would be impediments or distractions to their successful learning. Next, expert learners have first, declarative knowledge, second, procedural knowledge, and third, conditional knowledge. Declarative knowledge know what are the facts and verbal information. This includes a number of knowledge sets and consisting of known facts and active goals. The facts and information is learned quickly. So, declarative knowledge is also usually explicit knowledge, meaning that you are consciously aware that you understand the information. Next, procedural knowledge know how to perform various cognitive activities. This includes knowledge of methods of collecting, arranging, and processing data, knowledge of ways of interpreting and writing. Therefore, procedural knowledge provides learners with the knowledge they need to solve problems. problem solving occurs at a time when the individual must determine a way to achieve a goal that has never been achieved before. It's important to understand that procedural knowledge is built on declarative knowledge and that the two are often connected. Each learning process, according to this, goes through the following stages. It starts with cognitive or declarative learning, where we learn rules, then progresses to associative or procedural learning, where we learn how to apply rules, make connections, and improve fluency, and finally, to autonomous learning, where we achieve efficiency in remembering and applying learned knowledge. Next, conditional knowledge know when to use a specific metacognitive strategy and why it is helpful. This requires the use of logical thinking and problem-solving skills, as well as a deeper understanding of declarative and procedural knowledge. Learning process is also required, ideally by work in knowledge sharing. Therefore, knowing when and why to use declarative and procedural knowledge, as well as when not to use them, is a classification of conditional knowledge contained in long-term memory. So now, how does a novice learner differ from an expert learner? First, in novice learner, they don't stop to evaluate their comprehension of the material. They don't examine the quality of their work or stop to make revision as they go along. While in expert learner, their declarative knowledge has become proceduralized and incorporated into routines that can be applied automatically without any effort on their working memory. Second, novice learners don't make connections or see the relevance of the learning material to their lives. They are busy learning new declarative knowledge and thinking about each step in a new procedure to apply this knowledge. While in expert learner, they are more aware than novices of when they need to check for errors, why they fail to comprehend, and how they need to redirect their efforts. Next, a reading example to compare a novice and an expert learners. In novice learner, they would go onto the next page thinking that just reading the words on a page is enough, while expert learners would reread the page until the main concept is understood or flag a difficult passage to ask for clarification from an instructor or peers later. They have techniques to ensure they understand what they are reading. The goal for all teachers is to help students become expert learners. I think this is more important in our Korean culture. With new information accessible to people at any time through technology, it becomes increasingly important for people to be able to read and apply information they have learned. Now, let us have an activity for us to truly understand the difference of a novice and an expert learner. In this activity, you will just identify if it's a novice or an expert learner. Okay? Number 1. In problem solving, these learners try first to understand the problem, look for boundaries, and create a mental picture of the problem. It is a novice or an expert learner. The answer is expert learners, because in novice, they are satisfied at just scratching the surface. They rush to have a solution to the problem. 2. In selecting and processing, these learners attempt to process all information they receive. Is it a novice or an expert learner? answer is novice. Since expert learners will choose what's most important to process and be able to break down into small parts. 3. In learning or thinking strategies, these learners employ rigid strategies that may not be appropriate to the task at hand. Is it a novice or expert learners? Again, it is novice, since expert learners will design new strategies that would be appropriate to the task at hand. 4. In production of output, these learners check their errors and redirect their efforts to maintain quality output. Is it a novice or expert? Yes, the answer is expert learners. 5. In knowledge in different areas, these learners have deeper knowledge in different subject areas because they look for interrelationship in things they have done. Is it a novice or expert learners? The answer is expert learners, since novice learners have limited knowledge in the different subject areas. That's all for my report. Thank you for listening and have a good day.